गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस वीडियो इज़ फॉर क्लास 7 सब्जेक्ट मैथमेटिक्स। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डू द रिविजन ऑफ चैप्टर ट्राइंगल्स। इन योर बुक इन दिस चैप्टर वन एक्सरसाइज देयर ऑफ कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ ट्राइंगल। सो वट इज़ योर ट्राइंगल? वी ऑल नो ए ट्राइंगल हैज़ ए थ्री एंगल्स, द सम ऑफ ईच इज 180 डिग्री, एंड अ ट्राइंगल इज़ ए क्लोज प्लेन फिगर बॉन्डेड बाई थ्री लाइन सेगमेंट्स। Okay, and you also know there are different types of triangles are there, like right angle triangle, equilateral triangle, scallion triangle and isosceles triangle. So if you know these properties of all these triangles, so it is easier for you to draw the construction, because in the questions sometimes only little dimensions are given there, and by using the properties of the triangle you have to identify the sum of the dimension by your side. Like if I say the in equilateral triangle only one side is given to you, like FG is given to you in a question that they have given, FG is equals to 4 cm, and they are asking for draw a triangle. So many of the students are getting confused that only the one sides are given, so how we can construct a triangle. So you should know the properties of every triangle. So we know that in equilateral triangles all side equals, so if FG is 4 cm, so it means all side will be of your 4 cm. In a question, if they have given like two sides were there where UV is 4 cm and TV is your given 6 cm, and at last it is saying that it is an isosceles triangle. So if you are not knowing the property of isosceles triangle, you know that in isosceles triangle the two sides are equal. So if this one will be 6 cm, this one is also going to be a 6 cm. Okay, and for constructing of right angle triangle, in question like it is coming like this way: draw a right angle triangle ABC where BC is given 8 cm and AB is given 10 cm. Okay, and angles are not mentioned over there, but in the question they have said right angle triangle, and we know in a right angle triangle the one angle is of your 90 degrees. So first we'll construct the BC, and on the BC we're going to construct the 90 degree of angle over here, on which we are going to draw the 10 cm of line. Okay, so let's move further. We will see that types of questions are given in your exercise. Okay, what will happen when three sides are given to you in a question? When three sides are given to you, suppose if I have taken that AB is of 8 cm is given, BC of your 9 cm, and AC is given your 10 cm. So how you are going to construct this one? Okay, sometimes in a question, like I told you the example of equilateral triangle, okay, they have given that AB of AB only, they have given AB 8 cm, BC 8 cm, and AC is also 10 cm. Okay, so equilateral triangle also you can draw it by taking all the three sides. Same for applying for the isosceles triangle, one is given 8 cm and two are given for the 9 cm. Okay, so by using the three sides we can construct the equilateral triangle, okay, isosceles triangle and scalar triangle on the basis of the question. So see, first we have to draw the triangle ABC. Triangle, draw a rough figure first, ABC, where AB is given 8, BC is given 9, and AC is given 10 cm. So first we will construct it. AB first, line segment of how much? 8 cm. Mention the line segment over here. AB is given of how many centimeter? 8 cm. Now for gaining this vertex C, what you have to do, the BC and AC, in both the line segments C is coming. Okay, so for getting this vertex point C, you have to take an arc of 9 cm and 10 cm from the respective vertices like A and B. So first I am going to measure the 9 cm, because BC is given 9 cm. See, I have measured here, BC is coming 9 cm. Now, keep your compass pointer at vertex B here and take an arc. And whenever you are drawing an arc, please take it with a single go only, because sometimes you people are doing again and again and this line is becoming bold. So, in a single go, you just draw an arc. Now, AC is given 10 cm. only one more centimeter you have to take. AC is of 10 centimeter. Keep your compass pointer at point A and make an arc. So wherever you are getting this intersection point of a 2 arc, this point will be known as your vertex C. Join the line. BC, which is given 9 centimeter to us, and AC is 10 centimeter. So here we are having a triangle when three sides are given to us, okay, and by using these three sides, if they are asked for draw an equilateral triangle in which all the sides are equal, so the same way you have to do, draw the 8 centimeter of line, and if equilateral triangle it is saying, so means that the 8 centimeter of line, from here you take one arc, and from the A point also you take one arc of 8 centimeter and you will get your equilateral triangle. If isosceles they are asking for, draw 8 centimeter of line, and let's suppose that two sides are of 9 centimeter, so one arc from B point, okay, keep a compass pointer here, one arc from the B, one arc from the A, and you will get your isosceles triangle. So this one we are doing when we are having all the three sides with us. Coming to the next, what you have to do when one side and two angles are given. Okay, one side in a triangle, one side, okay, and with this side, two angles are given to you. Okay, so suppose I am taking this one AB as in 6 centimeter, okay, 6 or 8 we can take, okay. And the two angles were there, so two angles can be, if by using this one you can also draw isosceles triangle. If the opposite sides are equal, their opposite angle will be also equal. So if we are going to take this one is 30, so this one will be also 30. Or if you want to take a separate angle for both of them, so I am taking this one as in 30 degree and this one as in 60 degree, okay. So first we will draw a line segment of 8 centimeter. Okay, from 1 to 9 I am drawing because over here on my scale the curve is here. So from 1 to 9 is your 8 centimeter only. So this one is your 8 centimeter and name is line segment AB. Okay, now you can see if BAC is 30 degree and ABC is your 66 degree. It means at point B we have to construct 60 degree angle. Okay, so keep you already have studied in the class for constructing a 60 degree. What you have to do? We have to take a semicircle and the first arc will be with the same measurement is your 60 degree. Okay, like see again, keeping a compass pointer on point B. From this line segment only, draw a semicircle line. And the first arc will be your 60 degree. Okay, now BAC is given 30 degree. It means at point A we have to construct 30 degree. So how you have to construct? First, keep your compass pointer here. Draw a semicircle. First arc of your, from the starting point of a semicircle is your 60 degree, as we all know. And 30 degree is an half of 60 degree. So we are going to bisect this angle 60. So whenever you are bisecting the any of the angle, whether it is 120, 90 degree or 60 degree, how you have to bisect? First arc will take from the starting point of the semicircle, okay, somewhere here, and one arc you will take from 60 degree, the angle which you are going to bisect. Okay, so see, for the B point we have drawn the 60 degree of line, this one, so we are going to construct the 60 degree by joining this lining here. Okay, till now we didn't get a vertex C here. How you will get? When you will draw a 30 degree angle from point A. So see, as I have drawn the 30 degree over here, you will see that there is an intersection of this two line. The line which we have taken from the 30 degree from point A and 60 degree from point B, you will get an intersection point. When you will extend this line, you will get an intersection point, and this intersection point will be your C. This one. And for checking whether your construction is accurate or not, you can say, you can use the property of sum of all angle of triangle is 180 degree. Like this one is 60, this one is 30. 60 plus 30, your 90 degree. And we know the sum of all angle is your 180 degree. Okay. If you will do the subtraction, you will get 90 degree. It means the angle C came your 90 degree. Okay. So if you are having your protractor with you, you can measure this angle. If it is coming 90 degree, it means your construction is your correct. Coming to the next one. When two sides are given and one angle are given to you. Two sides and one angle. Okay. So I am taking AB as an 8 cm and BC as an 7 cm. Okay. And angle CAB I am taking 60 degree. So construct an AB line of 8 cm. AB of 8 cm, BC 7 cm, where CAB is your angle is given 60 degree, which means at vertex A you have to draw a 60 degree of angle. Okay, so same thing, take a compass, take a measurement is totally your choice. Okay, you want to take more than half of the line, you can take. If you want to take smaller than the line, you can take. The thing is, you have to keep in mind, you have to just draw the semicircle from the line segment, and we know the first arc is over 60 degree. Draw the line from the point A, which is passing through the arc, semicircle here. So this here we have made an angle 60 degree. Now see, BC is given as 7 cm from point B. We have to take an arc on this line so that we can get the vertex C. So this is 7 cm. This one is our, this intersection point is our vertex C. Join this line. Okay, so here you are having a triangle ABC when two sides are given to us. Okay, two sides are given to us and one angle at A. Okay, you can, if sometimes also in the question it is given that angle B is given to you. Instead of A, angle B is given to you. The same thing you have to do. You have to construct a 60 degree angle over here. Draw the 60 degree angle of line and measure the 7 cm. Okay, suppose in this one, if suppose AC is given to us 7 cm with an angle 60 degree. So what I will do first, I will construct the 60 degree first. Then I will measure the 7 cm AC. And from point A, I will take an arc like this way. Okay, now over also here we get an vertex C and we can join the BC. Coming to the next, how to do a right angle triangle when sides are given to you. Okay, sides are, suppose I am constructing a right angle triangle ABC. AB is given, I am taking as an 8 cm and AC I am taking as an 10 cm. So how you construct a right angle triangle? So by the name only you are getting that right angle triangle, which means one angle will be of your 90 degree. So I am taking angle A, suppose in the question it is given 90 degree. So first what you will do, draw a line of AB of 8 cm. AB is of your 8 cm. At point A we have to construct 90 degree. So keep your compass pointer at point A, draw a semicircle. Okay, now for constructing a 90 degree, we are taking first angle of 60 degree and again one more angle from 60 plus 60 you will get 120 degree, and we know 90 degree is coming between 60 to 120 degree. So one arc from 60 degree and one arc from 120 degree. This intersection of the arc is 90 degree. Draw a line segment at point A, which is passing through this intersection. This one is your 90 degree. This one is your 90 degree. This one is your 90 degree. Now construct BC of 10 centimeter. BC of 10 centimeter. BC of 10 centimeter at the line where you have drawn an angle 90 degree. So here this is your point C. Join this line segment BC, and here you are having the right angle triangle ABC, where BC is your 10 centimeter. So such types of questions are given there in your exercise. Do practice them. Thank you, students.